is up, you guys? Welcome back to another one. If you are new to the channel, I am Gold Pony. I do new car, truck, SUV reviews on YouTube. And today, we are in the brand new 2022 Kia Carnival, courtesy of Kia. So I've had it for almost about a week now. This thing is quite impressive. And so I was excited. I asked to check this one out because for the 2022 model year, of course, the Kia Sedona is now gone and replaced by the new Carnival, which actually existed across the globe, just not in the US, at least until the model year of 2022. So the Carnival, of course, will be competing with other vehicles like the Toyota Sienna, like the Honda Odyssey, like the Chrysler Pacifica. Plenty of unique characteristics to this one. I'm gonna be showing you guys all of those things that you probably have never seen on a van before. And of course, to go along with that, you do have America's Best Warranty as well, being 5-year, 60,000-mile bumper to bumper, 10-year, 100,000 miles on the powertrain. And so in this video, I will be testing out everything about this one, from acceleration to braking, steering feel, ride quality, sound system, exhaust clip, all of that fun stuff. So having said all of that, what do you guys say? Let's just go ahead and jump right into it. And as always, let's start with pricing. So as you can expect, there are several different trim levels for the 2022 Carnival. First one being the LX, starting at $32,100. LX seat package for $34,100. EX for $37,600. SX for $41,100. And lastly, the one we have today being the SX Prestige, starting at $46,100. But so regardless of trim level that you end up going with, the power plant on the Carnival is going to be the same. Powering this beast is a 3.5-liter direct injected V6, putting out 290 horsepower at 6,400 RPM, 262 pound-feet of torque coming in at 5,000 RPM. Power sent to the front wheels through an 8-speed automatic, giving you a 0 to 60 time coming in at approximately 7.5 seconds. We will test that out in a little bit here, of course. MPG numbers for the Carnival come in at 19 in the city, 26 on the highway, taking regular unleaded fuel. And so before we do any kind of fun acceleration test here in the Carnival, I did want to mention the drive mode. As I said, there is a drive mode button that is located directly behind the shifter. When you press that, you have normal, eco, sport, and smart, adjusting things like the shift points, the throttle response, and the steering sensitivity as well. And not to mention the gauges. That is one of the sweetest adjustments when it comes to the drive modes. And I'll show you guys the gauges a little bit later in the video, but it completely changes the look. It's absolutely awesome. I love it. But so anyways, now having got all of that out of the way, what do you guys say? Let's go ahead and find a straightaway here. Let's put the Carnival here to the test and let's see how quickly we can get this one here up to speed. All right, you guys, this looks like a good spot in 3, 2, 1. A little bit of spinning, not much though. Not bad. It's certainly not going to have any issues merging onto the highway in this thing. That was actually a decent acceleration. Now, having said that, like I said, there was a little bit of spinning, so wouldn't have minded maybe an all-wheel drive system just to connect a little bit better with the road there. Not only that, of course, the snow as well, but that was really good acceleration, honestly, for a van without a doubt. So let me just put it that way. Again, you're not going to have any issues emerging onto the highway. That was kind of fun. But anyways, to go along with that acceleration, as always, braking is equally important. And so up front, you will find 12.8-inch ventilated front discs. In the back, 12.8-inch solid rear discs. As far as that 60-to-0 stopping distance goes, let me tell you guys right now, 118 feet. If you were to compare that to the three main competition for this thing, the Sienna comes in at 131 feet, the Odyssey comes in at 124, and the Pacifica 130. So 118 feet does take the prize as far as braking goes. And as far as the braking feel goes, it's perfectly fine. It certainly brings you to a very nice stop. It's not too soft. Not on the firm side either, but it definitely is just right for what this vehicle is. I'll just put it that way. So braking is excellent. That's definitely something I want to emphasize, because when you need to come to a quick stop, maybe on the highway and you got kids in the car, you don't want to get into an accident. So braking is definitely very important. But anyways, then touching on suspension and handling, up front you're going to get a McPherson strut front suspension, in the back independent multi-link rear suspension, of course front and rear stabilizer bars. As far as the ride quality goes, I will say I was kind of impressed. I still am kind of impressed, of course, I'm still driving it, but the ride quality actually took me by surprise. It is a very smooth ride, believe it or not, even without an adaptive suspension, even without an air suspension. Again, for what this vehicle is, I think it rides a lot smoother than most of the SUVs that I test out, to be quite honest. So I was kind of surprised there. Ride quality is quite nice here in the Carnival, without a doubt. As far as steering feel goes, it definitely leans towards the looser side. It's pretty much as expected, so you're not going to get that crisp feel instantly pointing you in the direction that you want to go. But again, that's not really expected. It's definitely a looser steering feel, without a doubt. As far as cabin noise goes, it was okay. And let me emphasize a little bit on that, because it actually is going to differ amongst the trim levels. So for all trim levels, you will get an acoustic laminated front windshield. For the SX trim levels only, you're also going to get acoustic laminated front door glass. But at higher speeds, for whatever reason, you do get a little bit of wind noise coming from the driver's side, at least. So there is a little bit of that, and that's something that Hyundai, Kia, even sometimes Genesis is known for. But I will say it's not bad. I've heard worse, but there is a little bit of wind noise coming from the driver's side at higher speeds, at least. But at lower speeds, it's pretty serene cabin, I will say that. So overall, no issues with the cabin noise, besides that little bit coming from the driver's side. But then touching on visibility, I can see perfectly fine out the back, to be quite honest. One of the best parts about that visibility is that the third row headrest, they actually tuck down into the seat. So if there are not anybody in that third row, it certainly presents better visibility back there. So that is a big win for me. And if you were to go with the SX Prestige trim level only, you will also get a blind view monitor as well. Essentially what that is, so when you put on the turn signal, it's actually going to display what is in your blind spot up on the digital gauges up front here. And it's actually quite good as well. I actually prefer that to like the blind spot monitoring system found in the side mirrors, because it gives you more of a range of what is in your blind spot than you would otherwise get. So I absolutely love that. But having said all that, that about rounds out the performance segment of this review, guys. Let's now go ahead and find a really nice spot here on the lake, and let's take a look at the exterior of our brand new 2022 Kia Carnival.
All right, so here she is, you guys, the new 2022 Kia Carnival, finished in Astra Blue. In case anybody was curious of our exterior color name, beautiful here on the lake. I thought it went pretty well with the color of this thing. But anyways, very SUV-like styling for this van, which I absolutely love. Very nice look to it, especially up front. There's so many cool little aspects and quirks to this thing. So let's go ahead and start up front where the quirks begin here. Silver painted rectangular designed front grille for the LX trims and the EX. And there will be a matte chrome finish then for the SX trims. And that, of course, is what you guys are looking at right now. Silver accents on the front bumper for the LX trims and also the EX. Then you will get satin chrome finish then for the SX trim levels, of course. Multi-reflector halogen headlights coming with the LX trims and also the EX as well. And then full LED headlights coming with the SX trim levels. And of course, they will come with the automatic feature, meaning when it starts to get dark out at night, those headlights will turn on automatically for you there. And of course, LED daytime running lights coming with that as well. And it's actually a very cool design to the LED daytime running lights. I love the way they designed that. So big fan of that. High beams are actually, if you guys can tell, let me show you guys real quick. Let me zoom in here. The low beams, of course, are on the side as expected, but the high beams are actually integrated then into part of the front grille. And so they're going to be in those upper corners of the front grille. So if you actually turn on your high beams, that is where you're going to be looking. So definitely a unique look to it. You wouldn't have thought they would be in the front grille, but I actually do like the design of that. I thought that was pretty cool. But anyways, new Kia front logo. You guys can see that located on the front portion of the hood there. That looks pretty darn good as well. I actually do really like the redesign of the logo as well. So pretty cool look to it. LED fog lights coming with the SX trims. You guys can see those down below. That's pretty cool. And you're actually going to get front and rear skid plates if you were to go with one of the SX trims as well. So did want to mention that too. But overall, again, very SUV-like styling, very good look up front here. Let's now go ahead and make our way to the side of the Carnival. All right, so now since we are to the side, let's go ahead and start up top there. Roof rails coming with the SX trim level only. Rear privacy glass coming standard across the board. Black window surrounds coming standard across the board. But my favorite part about the side profile to the Carnival is that C-pillar. You guys can see there is a diamond pattern design on the C-pillar there. It's gonna come with a satin chrome finish for the SX trim levels, and then a silver finish if you go with the LX trims or the EX trim. So that is a pretty cool looking design. It's like nothing else really on the road. And again, I love the diamond pattern aspect, which actually they carry that design aspect into the interior of the Carnival then as well. And I'll show you guys that in the next segment of this review. But chrome accents on the door handles also coming standard across the board. body colored power adjustable side mirrors coming standard. They will be heated for all trim levels as well, with integrated turn signals for all trim levels as well too. Power folding side mirrors coming with the SX trim levels. So when you lock or unlock this thing, those power folding side mirrors will fold in or out, of course. Taking a look down at the bottom, you will find silver accenting on the side skirts across the board. And then taking a look down at the wheel configuration, 17 inch silver painted alloys for the LX trims, 19 inch machine finished alloys then for the EX, and 19 inch gloss black alloys then for the SX trim levels. So that is how they're going to be set up. But I will say, these gloss black wheels with all of our other satin chrome accents on this thing, I think they would have looked pretty darn good in maybe a machine finished or a silver painted finish as opposed to the black ones. But there is black windows surround, so overall definitely a very nice profile. Let's now go ahead and make our way to the back of the Carnival. All right, and so now since we are around back all the way to the top, body colored shark fin antenna just below that rear spoiler with an integrated brake light. Just below that, there is a rear window wiper, believe it or not. And actually, let me actually show you guys. It's not affixiated to the rear glass. It's actually tucked away up underneath of that rear spoiler, if you guys can see that. Kind of like the Chevy Suburban and the Chevy Tahoe. That is what they do as well. And actually, I prefer that because it's better visibility. You don't have that rear windshield wiper blocking anything, although it's not bad with it. I'm just saying it's a little bit better without it. But anyways, LED taillights do come standard on the EX and the SX trims. And not only that, you guys can see it's just a horizontal kind of design to it. But once you actually get the lights on, it is a pretty cool design to those LEDs. So I did want to show that to you guys here. I did take a night shot. So again, you wouldn't think it would be designed that way, but it is a pretty cool look back there. But anyway, silver or satin chrome tailgate accents, again, dependent upon which trim level that you go with. You do have Carnival lettering found on the bottom left-hand portion of that rear tailgate there. And of course, just below it all, you will actually find a single exhaust outlet tucked away. So having said that, I do believe you guys know what we have to do next. As always, here is that exhaust clip. All right, so now since we are around back of the Carnival, when it comes to opening that rear tailgate, there are several different ways to go ahead and do that. First way is there is a hands-free power tailgate for the SX trims and of course the EX then as well. So that is one way. There is also a button on the key fob itself. Simply just press down and hold that. That is another way. There is a button, of course, on the lift gate itself then as well. But once opened up, cargo capacity comes in at 40.2 cubic feet behind that third row, which actually is a decent amount. It was a pretty deep cargo area as well. So a lot of times you're not gonna find that much storage that actually goes down that deep. So that is pretty cool. So if that was not enough space, of course, that third row does fold down. There's a 60-40 split there. And it was pretty easy to fold that third row down. There's simply a lever and then a string that you pull on, and then it can actually fold down into that cargo area that you were just looking at, of course, and that bumps it up pretty substantially. And then overall, when it comes to overall cargo capacity, that comes in at 145.1 cubic feet. So for comparison's sake, let's compare it to the Honda Odyssey, 144.9. So little bit more, but really they are about the same when it comes to cargo capacity. So a very good bit of space. And if you were comparing this maybe to the Kia Telluride, it's going to come in at right around 87 cubic feet. So this is going to have more space than the Telluride, in case you were comparing those. But anyways, did want to also mention, if you did need all of that cargo capacity, again, the third row is going to fold down into that cargo area, and there actually is a removable second row, so you can completely remove those second row seats if you wanted to. So did want to mention that as well. But anyways, also in that cargo area, you of course will find some LED lighting here for our SX trims. There is plenty of grocery bag hooks. There is also little cubby or storage areas found on the sides. That was pretty cool. I liked seeing that. There is a 12 volt power outlet back there as well, and to my surprise, a 115 volt power outlet. So that is pretty cool too. So I can maybe charge up my Gerald back there if I wanted to. But anyways, so now go ahead and make our way to the rear legroom for the third row. That is going to come in at 35.6 inches, which actually is kind of impressive, to be honest, for a third row. For reference, I'm an even 6 feet tall. This is how much space I had in that third row. Did want to also mention though, for all trim levels, you will find third row
USB charging ports. You almost never find that. So if you had some third row passengers, some kids in the third row, they will stay charged up. Their tablets or phones will stay charged up. So that was pretty cool to see. Rear ventilation, of course, coming standard for all trim levels. That is actually found on the roof or the ceiling of this Carnival. That is pretty cool as well. And you will find some third row cup holders and the very best part, in my personal opinion, third row rear window sunshades. You never find that. I've never seen that before, even on Mercedes, BMW, things like that. Usually the second row window sunshades, yes, but never the third row. So that was pretty darn cool, at least to me. But anyways, let's now go ahead and make our way up to the second row legroom. That is going to come in at 40.5 inches. So for reference, again, I mean, even 6 feet tall, this is how much space I have back there. Of course, second row USB charging ports do come standard. That 115 volt power outlet coming with the SX trim levels only. We'll also get another one of those for the second row passengers. Pretty cool. Tri-zone climate control coming with the EX trim level and up, meaning those rear passengers can set their own temperatures then as well if they wanted to. Second row window sunshades can also be found back there. And I know everyone's going to ask, when it comes to 8-passenger versus 7-passenger seating, does depend upon the trim level that you go with. So here's the breakdown there. If you go with the EX trim or the SX trim, you will find 8-passenger seating and also the LX seating package. That is going to give you 8-passenger seating as well. Then if you wanted the captain's chairs in the second row or 7-passenger seating, go with that bottom LX trim level or the top SX Prestige. That is how you're going to go ahead and get the captain's chairs. But anyways, VIP lounge seats. Let me emphasize so much on these right now, for coming for the SX Prestige that we have today. And so of course, those second row seats can fold all the way down, but then you got the footrest as well. That is the lounge portion of the lounge seats, and that is absolutely amazing. You never see that in anything other than luxury vehicles like Mercedes-Benz or something like that. So I was a huge fan of that, and I did play around with that quite a bit. It was pretty cool and quite relaxing. You can definitely see yourself relaxing back there, maybe on a lunch break or something, or maybe your kids just want to take a nap in that second row. I don't know, but they were pretty cool. Not to mention the headrest, and I don't think Kia even lists that as a feature on their website, but if you guys look at those second row headrests, it kind of goes with the napping theme. They're like pillows, man. They're even more comfortable than the first row headrest for the driver and passenger. They're pretty darn cool, absolutely amazing. So definitely a very nice setup if you wanted to take a nap, at least in the second row. So pretty cool. Not to mention another cool factor with those seats is you of course can slide them forward and back, but they do actually slide left and right or horizontal. So that is a pretty cool feature. I was not expecting to see that either. There's a little bit of storage just in front of those second row passengers then as well. And by the way, the USB charging ports, in case anybody was curious, they're found on the side of these front row seats. So that is because typically the alternative is putting in the back portion of this center armrest, and then people that are getting into the second row here sometimes trip on the cords or the cables or whatever. So if you put them on the sides of these front row seats, kind of eliminates that issue. But perhaps my favorite part about those second row passengers, the way they got it set up there, is the rear seat entertainment system coming with the SX Prestige. And so there's really two different setups you can go with. There's kind of the adult setup and the kids setup. If you were to go with the kids setup, you have two options. You have YouTube Kids, which of course my kids are personally obsessed with. And then you have the Baby Shark app, which is pretty freaking cool. So tons of different Baby Shark songs, not just your typical Baby Shark song, but also ABCs, 1, 2, 3s, all that fun stuff. So I thought that was pretty darn cool. So if you have kids, you understand how important these things are to keep your kids happy in the second row, so you don't have to listen to the whining or whatever. That is pretty cool. Well done, Kia. I love that. And there's also sounds of nature back there, which are kind of new. A lot of these sounds of nature are new for Kia slash Hyundai slash Genesis. So I haven't seen them before, and they're different actually than what is in the front. So kind of interesting there. But anyways, I'll play the sounds of nature once we get to the front infotainment portion here. But overall, rear seat entertainment system was absolutely wonderful, and I love that they are back there, especially if you have kids, you will appreciate that. But so anyways, let's now go ahead and make our way to the front seats on this thing. 6-way manually adjustable cloth seats coming with the LX. LX seat package then adds Syntex upholstery, a 10-way power driver seat with 2-way power lumbar, heated front seats then as well. And then if you were to go with the EX, it's going to be essentially the same as the LX seat package. SX trim level is going to add an 8-way power adjustable passenger seat, also ventilated front seats then as well. And then lastly, if you go with the SX Prestige that we have today, you will find full perforated leather seating. So a very nice feel to it. And overall, seat comfort was absolutely fine. Again, when they are 10-way power adjustable with power lumbar, you're definitely not gonna have any issues there. But now let's go ahead and make our way to the steering wheel. It is tilt and telescoping, of course. It is leather wrapped. If you were to go with the LX seat package trim level and up, that is how you're going to go ahead and get that. And if you wanted a heated steering wheel, you were going to have to go with the SX Prestige trim level that we have today. That's how you're gonna go ahead and get that. But now let's go ahead and make our way to the startup. It is a pretty fancy key here. You do have your Kia logo, your new Kia logo on the one side, along with a few buttons, including your remote start, which you simply hold down for. Oh, by the way, that remote start does come standard on all trim levels, by the way, even the LX. That is pretty cool. Then the two buttons just below that are going to be the power opening side doors, in case you were curious about them, which is pretty cool. And then all of the rest of your buttons are located on the side of the key. You got lock, unlock, and that button to pop the rear tailgate, of course, as well. But now, of course, it is a push button start for all trim levels across the board. So all I'm going to do here is simply put my foot on the brake and press that engine start button located just below the air vents there. But then once started up, another one of my favorite parts about this one, now we'll say it does differ. Analog gauges are going to come with all trim levels, but the SX Prestige that we have today, because the one that we have today is going to be the 12.3 inch digital gauge cluster. And so this is my favorite. I have digital gauges in my car, my Hyundai Sonata. I love them. I love this as well. And the best part about these gauges, let me just show you right off the bat. When you change the drive modes, let's say you're in Eco, it's going to give you these blue hues. If you put it in Sport, it's going to give you red and silver. If you put it in Smart, you're going to get some black hues along with Normal as well. But overall, the gauges just change up so much. It really allows you to customize it, and I absolutely love that. Definitely a very sick looking gauge cluster if you ask me. But of course you can completely adjust that by using the steering wheel mounted controls found on the right side of the steering wheel here. I have the digital readout of my speed up there right now, but there's also a compass you can display up there, tire pressure, safety information at any given time. There's the driver attention monitoring system, trip A, trip B, of course, when you need your next oil change. Also how many miles you have left until you hit empty. I always like to mention that one, because right now we got 369 miles left until empty, and we got right around a full tank, although I have been driving a good bit today. So that is a decent amount of range here for the Carnival, I will say that. So overall, love the gauge cluster. And again, when you put your turn signal on, you have that blind spot view monitor displaying up in the digital portion of the gauges as well. And you do need that digital gauge cluster for the blind spot view monitor, so I do want to mention that. But anyways, let's not go past the gauges. Let's make our way to overall interior quality. Dual power sunroofs coming with the SX Prestige. Essentially what that means is the driver and passenger have their own personal sunroof, and the second row passengers also have theirs as well. It's found towards the back there. So, and they are separated. It's a pretty cool look. But LED interior lighting, wanted to mention that to you guys, coming with the SX Prestige that we have today. I did wake up at 5 something this morning, so I was able to show that to you guys when it was a little darker out. So that is what, of course, I am showing you right now. It's a pretty cool look. I love LEDs on the interior. Audio dimming rear view mirror with HomeLink controls, coming with the SX Prestige trim level only. Wireless phone charger coming with the EX trim level and up. That is pretty cool. It's located just in front of the cup holders there. Tri-zone climate control coming with the EX trim level and up. There is 3D embossed accents coming with the SX trims. And again, there's 3D embossed accents. It kind of ties together with that exterior C pillar I was telling you guys about. It kind of brings that design just below the infotainment screen, just above the passenger side glove box. And it is a 3D effect. If you feel it, it's actually texturized. So it is pretty cool. I like that. It's a nice design element to the Carnival without a doubt. But I will say, if you go with the EX trim, it's going to differ a little bit, giving you open pore wood graphics. So a little bit different setup there. But overall, let me tell you guys, seriously surprised. The interior quality is almost flawless here in the Carnival. And I know specifically with the competition with other vans, you definitely do not get this type of interior quality. Of course, like I was just mentioning, just above the passenger side glove box, but if you look on the doors itself, you have a bunch of gloss black accents, which are extremely easy to clean. I have tons of those in my own vehicle. They're very easy to clean. Also, you have this very soft leather found on the doors, found in this cool orange color. I personally love that. You have a lot of soft touch material found just above those embossed accents.
accents with stitching going through that. You also have this nice silver accent line running right through the air vents there. That is pretty cool as well. Even the push button start is a nice silver finish to it as opposed to a plastic finish, which some other manufacturers do give you. I also like that all the climate control is digitalized, so that is pretty cool as well. But just in front of the shifter, you actually have three USB charging ports, a little bit of storage, and again, that wireless phone charger. Just to the right of the shifter, you have two cup holders, a little slot where you can put yourself in if you prefer to put it there. There's an electromechanical parking brake just behind the shifter then. All of your heated and ventilated seat buttons are going to be located just behind the cup holders. Yet again, there is a little bit more storage behind that. And within the center armrest, plenty of space within that as well. So overall, honestly, interior quality seriously surprised you. I think the only thing that can make the interior quality better is maybe if they brought that nice suede-ish headliner that they use in the Telluride onto the Carnival here. That would be the only thing I could possibly think of at this point. So overall, interior quality is stellar. I absolutely love it. But now let's go ahead and make our way to the infotainment screen. 8-inch color touchscreen display coming with the LX and the LX seat package. 12.3-inch color touchscreen display coming with the EX trim level and up. Both are going to give you Bluetooth and audio streaming. Both will give you Android Auto, Apple CarPlay. Factory navigation system is going to come with the EX trim level and up, but in addition to that, you also get a voice memo system, which I always find is pretty cool. You can record your voice and then play it back at a later date if maybe you didn't want to forget something or something like that. Sounds of nature, again, like I was telling you guys about for the rear passengers, they have a little bit more options back there, believe it or not, but let me go ahead and take a break here and just play you guys some of those sounds of nature just so you know what I'm talking about. I will be right back. So in addition to that, the quirky little features don't stop with the infotainment screen there. There is a quiet mode, which essentially turns off the volume for the rear speakers and then limits the volume to a certain number in the front. I believe it's maybe like 7. So if you have passengers in the back that are sleeping maybe with those second row lounge seats and you wanted to keep them asleep, quiet mode is going to assist you in doing that. But one of my favorite features is the passenger view button, their passenger view app that you can see up on the infotainment screen. So there's a little camera located on the ceiling here for the rear passengers. It's going to shine down. So if you wanted a better view of what the rear passengers are actually doing, maybe the kids are fighting or something, you have the ability to do that through this passenger view app. And you can even zoom in by using the kind of pinch and swipe motions to see better what they are doing or what they should not be doing, which is pretty darn cool as well. It's one of the coolest things I've found about the Carnival. And there's so many cool little quirks about this thing, let me tell you. But overall, definitely love the infotainment screen. It's of course massive at this 12.3-inch screen and actually ties in, of course, with the 12.3-inch digital gauges. So overall, I absolutely love it. But of course, you could check out the radio information as well. So let me now get to the sound systems here in the Carnival. 6 speakers coming with the LX trims, 8 speakers coming with the EX and SX. Then you will get a 12-speaker Bose sound system then for the SX Prestige that we have today. Pretty cool speaker design as well. But anyways, let's go ahead and turn on the radio now, see what we got playing this morning, and let's test out the clarity of this one. I haven't listened to country in a while, but that wasn't bad. I will say that was just standard radio. It wasn't Sirius XM or connection to my phone or anything like that. So the radio quality itself wasn't the best because that's what radio is these days. But still, not that bad of a sound system. I could definitely tell there was a ton of bass in this thing, plenty of clarity. So really, Bose sound systems, I've had them in my vehicles before. They've never failed me. They've never broken on me. So plenty of a sound system without a doubt for the Carnival. But last thing I wanted to mention to you guys is when you do put this thing in reverse, you will find a rear view camera coming standard across the board. Not only that, if you were to go with the SX trim levels, you're also going to get a surround view monitor, giving you that bird's eye view of everything all around you, and that, as always, is going to lead us into safety. And so to start, front side curtain airbags do come standard. Also, rear side airbags as well. That doesn't always come standard, and it's important in a van. Driver's knee airbag as well. In the back, you're gonna have latch, aka lower anchors and tethers for children, for the rear car seats, rear child door locks, tire pressure monitoring system, but also coming standard across the board, forward collision avoidance assist with pedestrian detection, driver attention warning,
lane departure warning, lane keep assist, lane following assist, high beam assist, rear cross traffic alert, rear parking sensors, and rear occupant alert as well. That's all the standard stuff that even comes on the LX trim level. That's crazy. But then if you were to go with the LX seat package, you're going to also get a blind spot collision avoidance assist system. Then the EX trim level and up is going to add to that forward collision warning with cyclist detection, front and rear parking sensors, a navigation-based adaptive cruise control system with stop and go, which by the way is an excellent system on all Kia, Hyundai, Genesis products. So definitely a very nice system there. And you also get actually highway drive assist then as well, which is a brilliant system. It's almost full autonomous driving. It's crazy. But anyways, SX trims are also going to add to that a parking collision avoidance assist system in reverse as well. So overall, when it comes to my final thoughts here of the Carnival, excellent exterior styling. I will say it's very SUV like for a van. I like that. I like the C-pillar design in the back there. Also love that the high beams are incorporated into the front grille. It's a unique element. Makes it like nothing else on the road. I absolutely love that. Very smooth ride quality as well for it not having an adaptive suspension system, I gotta be honest. So that is definitely a good thing for a family hauler like the Carnival. VIP seating in the second row, it's one of my favorite parts. So definitely a big fan of that. Overall, great tech on the Carnival as well, with the digital gauge cluster, with the 12.3 inch infotainment screen, with the ability to spy on the rear passengers from that infotainment screen, and so on. I could keep going on the tech all day. I feel like it's definitely very nice there. Great safety with highway driving assist. I have a feeling when this thing finally gets tested by IIHS, it's probably going to be a top safety pick plus, just because of all of the advanced safety that comes with this, because LEDs come standard on this thing. So that is definitely a big plus there as well. As far as room for improvement goes, again, the only thing I could possibly think of are two things. Maybe an extra suede headliner element, just like the Telluride perhaps, and also an all-wheel drive option I think would be pretty darn cool as well, just because the Sienna and the Pacifica, I believe as well, does have that option available. So overall, when it comes to my final thoughts here of the Carnival, I absolutely love this thing. It definitely makes you consider getting a van, especially if you have a family. I mean, so many people are going SUVs these days. That is kind of the craze, of course. But I will say, with all the utility, with all the practicality that this thing gives you, it's definitely hard not to consider this thing. This is a very serious contender when you actually get out and check this thing out, especially if you have kids. You cannot go wrong with the Carnival in the end. But overall, let me know what you guys think of the Carnival in the comment section below. That is about it for this one, you guys. Thank you so much for watching. Feel free to follow me on TikTok at the bottom of the screen if you wanted to see short clips of these vehicles before they actually get to YouTube. Be sure to hit the subscribe and the bell notification button if you're into new car reviews. That is what we do here on this channel. After all, do appreciate you guys watching more than you know, and I will see you guys all in the next video. Stay gold.